help you today understand how this golf ball can help you play your very, very best. It's telling you a story. The golf ball is telling us what's happening at the moment of impact. Understand, we're not going to try and get you to swing it like Tiger Woods. We're not going to try and get you to swing it like Natalie Gulbis. What we're going to try and get you to do is have control of this golf ball instead of having the golf ball control you. The impact factors we're talking about, there's four of them. The first one is the club face and how it arrives. The club face dictates curve. If the ball's curving in the air, the club face has arrived incorrectly. The second impact factor is what we call the swing path. That is referring to the direction of the golf swing. If your golf ball's starting offline, assuming that you've aimed correct, your swing path is either too much from outside in or too much from inside out. The third impact factor, the angle of approach, that controls the contact, the distance, and the trajectory that you hit shots. Ideally, the club, as it's swinging into the golf ball, is going to be traveling relatively level to the ground. If it's descending too much or ascending too much, it's going to rob you of power and, most importantly, contact and distance. And last but not least is club head speed. Well, you all have enough club head speed to play the game well enough, but you've probably applied it incorrectly if you've not gotten the distance results that you'd like. So understand, our goal is to help you play your very best, and this golf ball is going to help us accomplish that. As we talk about what's happening with the golf ball, it's directly correlated to impact, and I know if we can get you to understand that, we can get you to play your very best.